So here is iOS 14 versus Samsung's One UI. We'll see the user interface changes, the animations, what's new, and how much changes Apple has done or taken from Samsung's One UI. So this is the home screen where you will see so many changes. You can finally add widgets into the home screen between the applications. An exciting part is you can scroll between the widgets like this. There's no need to put another widget or something else, which is kinda cool. It's like just use the same area, same section and scroll between the widgets, which is not the case with Samsung's One UI. You can put widgets, but you need to put separate widgets which can mess the home screen. iOS 14 also comes with application drawer, yes sort of, and it is called application library. Now there are folders in folders which I personally don't like, but it's not something bad. I like the clean drawer of One UI where you can have your choice if you wanna put an application into the folder or not, but it's not something there in this application library of iOS. And next we finally have picture-in-picture mode, which is there in Samsung from quite a long time. Shocking part is you cannot use PIP in iOS Photos and some main applications, which is kind of disappointing. It only works in Safari and Netflix and video calls. In Samsung, you can use PIP in most applications. One thing Apple has done great is you can hide the PIP screen to side and still hear the conversation and all. Here are some animation difference in different applications. There's this control settings versus quick settings and notification panel. Yeah, the speed is still slow in iOS, which is quite disappointing because I was expecting the performance improvement also in the iOS 14. Settings also got many new options like home screen. You can customize the settings of application drawer, which is quite okay. We also have the brand new wallpapers, both light and dark, depending on what you wanna use. I really like this thing, and so on. iOS 14 finally comes with compact calls, which doesn't take full screen to show who is calling, whether you want to pick up or not, you want to cancel that call or something else. Samsung has done this a few years back, so again, nothing new here. There are also some minor changes, like in iMessages, you can pin the conversation on the top. Now, one of the huge change is translate. There's conversation mode where conversation between two person with different language is easy. It's like a real-time translation, which again you can achieve via Google Translate in the Samsung's One UI. New Siri versus Bixby, the animations and icons look quite same. Siri is now fast and is better than Bixby in my opinion right now. And yes, in the end there are some minor changes. There's power saving mode, which is already there in Samsung's One UI. Battery notifications for connected devices like AirPods and some other minor changes. But all in all, this is the iOS 14 versus Samsung's One UI main difference. There's so much in One UI which Apple needs to implement in the future, and they'll do it slowly because if they take all of them at once, then there won't be anything to implement more. That's all. Which is your favorite UI, One UI versus iOS? Thanks so much for watching. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section, and I'll meet you guys in the next one. Peace out.